And good day, sir!
Welcome, everybody, to The Defense, where we keep our heads cool, our voices soft, and then the second that Saka casts a black hole, we go, oh my God! Quarter final! The first game was intense. The second game could be even better. Let's jump ourselves in there right now. Luckily, the man to keep me in check, to keep me cool, calm, collective, he is my expert. I don't know if you can do that, man. But he is my man. He joined me for the international when we did our commentating there. And since then, he has been slightly inactive. But luckily, he is back. He is in the studio. And I'm not going to mention the meme, which everybody wants to make of him. Slashman, welcome to the broadcast.
Yeah, thanks, you mentioned that.
I said nothing.
Yeah, sure you did. No, we're absolutely fine with that. To be honest, Toby, I think it's most of it's just your emotional shouting that keeps the people going and their blood running high. So, I was going to ask you what's your secret, but as I already know the answer is Red Bull, I'm not going to ask it anymore.
Actually, I haven't had Red Bull in a while. I've been drinking this other stuff called Wildfire this year. I'm going to say it gives me a little bit, but I bought two cans of Red Bull and I'm only like halfway through the first one. And I actually think my secret is just good Dota. That's the secret, man. Just have good Dota. And all of a sudden, like, you're jizzing in your pants, you're wearing tight jeans for a very good reason, is so that you hide your enjoyment from everybody who would insult you for it.
Yeah, it's like your roommate, the StarCraft caster.
Yeah. Yeah, he's behind that wall right there. He always feels like it's a competition as well. It's like, man, you can't. Like, StarCraft, like, it's good, but the excitement that comes from a game of Dota, from a team fight of Dota, that's the kind of stuff you just pump in through an IV. It's like, yes! Anyway, let's jump ourselves into the game to see our draft. Once again, we're not going to see Invoker as well as AM. This time around, though, because Come With Me has the first pick, he bans out Tidehunter instead. That way, he is just like praying to all gods that Invoker would get through the ban stage. He doesn't in this case, though, as he is banned out by Alex, as well as Chen being removed, and that's not surprising. Chen these days is considered to be the best support hero in the world. And we went through the phases of Lich when everyone's like, oh, we're going to go a late-game anti-mage kind of play. That doesn't happen these days. It's just like, push you down. Lich just becomes useless in the current metagame. But Prophet is made into the pool by Come With Me, and Windrunner and Nightstalker is the answers back here from the Dire.
Yeah, Nightstalker this time escaped the banning pool. Tidehunter was banned instead. So the Germans, they feel very confident of running that aggressive hero. He's still so strong in Dota 2 right now. And a few things switched around, really, because Windrunner this time picked up by Panzer, or Ariana as they are known right now, and Deepness has picked up Prophet, the global control hero, and which turned out to be one of the most crucial, really, for Ariana last game, simply because he Prophet sprouted Brutemother and Razor was standing outside while draining all her damage away. That was one of the main combos they actually pulled off, and very successfully at that. I still can't believe that Frieza threw that game so massively.
let's not reflect on that, man. I know what happens when you get massively depressed when a bad decision happens. I know you way too well. You'll be sitting there at night just going, you know what, Queen of Pain? I can't even play that hero now because it's going to remind me of what happened. Oh, man. Hang on.
I believe he was just incredibly overconfident right there. As in, he thought he could kill Enigma and make it out alive at the same time.
Yeah, there's only so much a Queen of Pain is able to do. You gotta remember, Queen of Pain is very, very squishy. Now let's check out our draft right now so we can talk about our current game and not the game which just passed. You'll be able to find that VOD up on joindota.com. It will be uploaded later today, as well as with the VODs from Friday night, which didn't actually make it up there. So I apologize for you guys. Only one of those ones made it up on YouTube. There were issues with things, which always seems to happen. But yes, those VODs will be coming up sometime soon. But let's check out our draft so far. So once again, we see a bit of a push. This time it's on the opposite foot. Technically, it's still the Radiant side, but the teams have swapped around. So Enigma as well as Prophet coming up for the Radiant side, Dignitas, which means they have the pushing power, they have the jungling, they have the massive map control. But...
Yeah, they do. But they picked up VS. I'm not quite sure if... I think VS been trending lately in Dota 2 because she's incredibly powerful in ganks. The one thing that she's really weak at is laning phase. She's got very low range, very low damage.
This is the time I blow your mind and ask, did you check out the recent Na'Vi games? Through the TPL as well as a couple of games in the last stages of the defense.
Oh yeah, I have.
So the VS Venno, the fact they ran that three times with VS running basically the carry role, solo, the dual lane mid of Venno and VS.
I thought they're very amusing and they're very, good ingenuity really, if you want to play VS as a core hero. But on the other hand, as I said, as support, she just can't, say, harass as much as an Ancient Apparition or a Lich could. Because she doesn't have that range to pull it off. Mm-hmm. But as dual laner, she's very strong. She's incredibly strong in getting kills and counter-killing. But as I said, as an harassment and lane control, she's just not that strong.
Mm-hmm. Just checking out our last pick. So we have Ancient Apparition done. If Alex is going to do the best thing he can do right now, and that is ban out the Beastmaster, because I know that Come With Me will be itching for that as their solo or their melee up against Nightstalker. It's exactly what they want. So I'm hoping Alex is going to be sharing my insight right now. Well, if I call it insight, at least my thought patterns. And banging out Beastmaster.
I have to compliment you, Toby, that your thought patterns have tremendously over the past.
Thanks, man. I've been working on it.
Oh yeah, I'm very sure you have. Yeah. After all, this is your job, isn't it?
Shh. We don't want people knowing that. It is. Shadow Shaman's being banned out. It almost feels like a copy of the lineup. The only thing which we're changing up is the fact that CM has been substituted for the Vengeful Spirit.
Currently, it looks like that, yes.
Yeah, and now Venomancer comes into the ban for Come With Me. So he's just like, you know what, screw it. Venno stalled you up last time, just a little bit, not really a lot, but he stalled you up last time. This time around, we're going to take him out. SK is already banned, so I'm wondering if the Dire... Seriously, ban out Beastmaster. If there's a Broodmother, you can deal with that. It's probably what Come With Me is looking at too, considering Venomancer as well as SK is taken out. But that still does leave Slaughter on the field.
Dignitas, they don't need any support heroes anymore, really. They ban out two support heroes. On the other hand, the Dire, I think they could really do with an Earthshaker. Earthshaker should be a very good pick here. Not only against the pushing power, as a counter with Dagger Echo Slam, but also to stop that Enigma Black Hole before he gets up his BKB. Radiant
team pick. Yes. Yes.
Well, because they ban on that Beastmaster, you really dislike the hero.
Yeah, I actually hate Beastmaster. It's really bad because I know he's such a great functional hero for everything you possibly need. You got an ultimate that goes through BKB. You've got a slowing pig. You got a way to clear off crit waves, and you've got a hawk which will give you vision as well as rune control every single time. But I always feel like he is just such a staller of a game every single time he plays, and it annoys the living crap out of me. But they needed to ban him out anyway because he would have been a great counter towards the Night Stalker, even though he would have been good in their hands considering Come With Me now grabs up Broodmother and they've got a lot of pushing power. All the Dire need to do is either grab a Bounty Hunter if they want to go for a bit of a hunting spree, or they could be looking for the normal pickup, which would be Slaughter.
Slaughter. Yeah. Slaughter as well as Earthshaker, I think, should be...
If you have Slaughter as well as Night Stalker on the field, that's... a little bit too much melee. You're going to have a hard time winning your lanes if that's the case.
I'm not quite sure. I think Slaughter together with an Ancient Apparition could work fairly well. Mm. Or Ancient Apparition together with Stalker, Windrunner supporting Slaughter.
But then what are you going to do for the rest of your lanes? Because at this point, Faceless Void? Okay, we can go with
void,
that. If all else fails, pick up a Void. They've got a lot of confidence that AA Windrunner and Nightstalker to control that middle game if they think Faceless Void's going to get enough farm. Because Void's going to get pushed hard. You got Prophet, Broodmother, and Enigma. Those tier 1 towers, well, I said this last time and I was proved completely wrong. Those tier 1 towers won't last too long with that kind of pushing power. All of a sudden, tier 1 towers, first one goes down 25 minutes into the game.
Yeah. Yeah, well, it's a bit they were caught on the back foot, I got to say. But Faceless Void, I'm not quite sure if this makes... Faceless Void together with Ancient Apparition is a very, very good combination. And I think they are thinking of picking up that Lich. Lich is also so powerful with Faceless Void. Lich or Witch Doctor could work very well.
I'd actually enjoy. Well, actually, Witch Doctor could have a little bit of trouble with the amount of treants as well as spilings that would come up. So it wouldn't be too bad for stalling down a wave, but you'd need to kill off that creep wave before it happened. And I don't really have any. Actually, that's one thing. That's one thing the Dire's lacking. Oh, Pugna. 10 seconds
remaining. You mean the Dire's could pick up Pugna?
They're gonna go Lich. Damn it.
It doesn't make sense. The Pugna would—he needs too much farm. They needed a support hero. Needed one to go with.
But
Void.
How are they going to stop the push? You got conversion spilings and treants running down at your tier one tower, and all you've really got is a power shot and an AA ulti and a frost.
It's about storming them. As in, Nightstalker is one of those heroes who just charges into the fray if he's tanky enough and takes out one guy.
Mm.
They counter push by ganking.
But if Dignitas get momentum before AA hits level 6...
That's very difficult.
Yeah.
This is very, very difficult, because AA is very reliant on his ultimate to function properly. Same as with Lich, really. Mm. Lich is incredibly strong hero, in my opinion, at least. Lich is one of the best heroes, or I think is one of the heroes who could even be first pick. Lane control, as well as a support hero that deals around half of the whole team's damage in a teamfight. This is massive.
Mm. All right, so once again, we have our pause to make it official at the very, very start. For all those guys from the World of Heroes of New Earth, you'll understand that joke. And if you're not from that world, welcome. This is the world of Dota 2. We're like a subspecies of communities. We're a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bit of Monica in my life, a little bit of Erica by my side. Yeah. How's that work? A little bit of Hon in my life, a little bit of Dota by my side, a little bit of LOL is what I need, a little bit of BF is what I see, a little bit of CES in the sun, a little bit of Call of Duty all night long, a little bit of Minecraft, here I am, a little bit of Dota 2 makes me your man, oh yeah.
I'm enjoying it, yeah, a lot.
See, we can make up songs, it's the Call of Duty song, man, it's the Call of Duty song. I mean, Dota 2 song. Damn it! I'm locked in Call of Duty. Why is my brain in Call of Duty?
While you're cursing Dota 2, that's a bit of a...
Well, I did start down the world of Call of Duty in Battlefield, so my brain can go back there. The only problem is every single time I go back there, it's massively depressing because I see the game they've created today and then just go, oh, that's just crap. Next thing I know, I'll be asked to actually commentate a Call of Duty competition. I'll be like, yeah, this game's awesome. What? No. You went back on your word. You're a liar. You're a traitor. A traitor to your own casting kind.
Mm. I actually just wanted to talk. I just figured that during the pause, you can only write one time. Damn it.
What did you just...
Spectators were out. What the fuck would Dignitas just say?
Were you about to actually like list it up saying, Windrunner's going to go solo bottom. Then we're going to have AA and Void in the middle. And then Lich and NS on top.
Lich Void on top, and AA, NS in mid. I'm fairly sure they're going to run it that way.
I'm going to challenge you. I reckon we're going to see Lich and Void in the middle lane, AA, NS top, and Windrunner solo bot.
Why is that the case?
Because I'm just such a boss, and that's going to be the case.
Oh, okay.
I have no... Actually, there is logical reasons behind it. Most of the time, whenever you have a big, big hard carry, they just seem to be running him in the middle lane all the time, be it Void, be it whoever. The only team which kind of goes against that is when they throw an Invoker up on the... Actually, no, it still works because they throw Invoker up on the top lane and then run like an anti-mage or Void in the middle lane if they're going to go that kind of path. But yeah, it's... Yeah. When you look at the lineup for Dignitas, she... You seem to know they've got four ranges out of this. How are they going to land this? Do we see Mirana go up towards that top? Do we see Prophet solo the top lane? And then you put VS and Brood on the bottom? We see Brood up on the top and Prophet on the and Mirana on the bottom with
a VS?
To be honest,
I got no idea how Dignitas are going to lane. I have no idea, because I think Prophet is going to be going the mid lane, really.
You think he's actually going to go for the hard rune control? Mid lane Prophet TP first level?
I believe so. I believe VS Brute Mother.
He knows it's going to be a hard lane, though. Because you know instantly that there's going to be a dual lane in middle. So you're going to be copying a lot of harassment, and you're going to have a double initiate on you.
I think they, well, yeah, double initiate. I know, as I said, it's very, very, I have no idea how they want to lane this.
I reckon if they're thinking AA is going to go in the middle lane, they're going to throw, and I'm going to call this really early, Mirana in towards the middle lane. If they think AA is going to be in there. That way, Nibiru can go jungle, Brew can go solo up his top lane and be all hunky-dory up there, and Prophet can get that very early farm on the bottom lane and give a lot to VS as well, so he can get his levels up.
I think they're fairly flexible, really. It all depends if they want to play Prophet as a core ganker or if they want to run him as a carry.
Mm-hmm.
And most of them start off with buying an Urn of Shadows anyway and to assist in ganks, early game ganks. Because of that global teleport, which is incredibly strong.
Yeah. Sometimes we even just see Prophets just TP, just so they can get the two Urn Charges. it's just not so they actually need it for the fight. It's just, I can be there. Urn Charge! Woo!
Yeah.
He's not skilled anything just yet, but I believe he's going to skill Force of Nature. Well, one of the two is going to be in the jungle anyway.
Yes. that's a guarantee. You get yourself like two of the best junglers in the game. It's like, Nah, we're gonna run both on lanes. We're gonna see Enigma solo top. we're gonna see VS and run and go in middle lane. Broodmother gonna have the bottom and Prophet. He can just roam.
Generally speaking, European teams do not like to run Enigma as a solo side laner.
Unless you're PGG. If you're PGG, he'll take it side lane solo every single time because he's PGG. It's just what he does.
That's a special case.
All right, so I don't know what is going on right now with the Germans.
Apparently, it is one Iran guy still smoking. So
it's a bad habit, guys. Kids, don't smoke.
Tell it to Kuro.
It's a habit for life.
You tell it to Kuro.
Kuro, stop smoking, man.
Yeah.
Stop smoking.
There we go.
Ah, the resume from Lich. So now we're good to go. Let's see who has got what ability and what has Prophet got. He's gone first level Nature's Call. He's going jungle.
Yeah, he's going to jungle because he's got the Basilius.
Why is Leon heading middle lane?
I don't really see the point.
Are they going to run Brood solo mid?
But who's going to go top then? Mirana solo top. Bottom solo top, well, possible.
No, we got the dual lane on bottom with the jungle. So Freeze going to take the role as Mirana. Zoo will be taking the role as VS. And then we'll have Coco playing the role as Enigma on the bottom lane. It's going to give us our tri lane. Come with me as running in towards the middle lane as the Prophet. I assume he is going to go top. And then Leon is going to go Broodmother solo mid. And we are going to have Lich as well as Faceless Void here in the middle lane. are you seeing the animation that Kuro is doing? That is just so awesome. Whoop, 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 whoop.
Yeah, he's doing the time warp cancel.
It's so awesome. Passively taking the role as the Windrunner on the bottom lane. Oh, that is just so great. Alex will steal one from the bottom, but he'll head towards the middle lane later. Saga will be taking the role on the top lane as the Ancient Apparition. And Leaf, the Night Stalker, up on the top. So, I am right, Sunny Jim. I am so right.
You were right.
Oh, yeah, I love it.
And
man.
I'm surprised you were, because I've no idea what Dignitas are thinking, because they're leaving top lane.
Yeah, this is...
I've no idea what they are thinking.
This isn't actually the first time they've done this, though.
Really?
This isn't the first time they've done a strat like this. And it always hinges around both Prophet and Enigma. It's a double jungle, but the second they both hit level 2, that tier 1 tower is gone. They just push really, really hard on that tier 1, and they don't stop. They go tier 2 as well. So Mirana will get a couple levels up, and then they'll just push. And Broodmother, in the meantime, will just hold the middle.
Jungle. VS is helping Enigma farm up the jungle right now.
Mm-hmm. The fact that the Dire of Wards actually is a really smart ward too. Stopping the creep camp spawning.
Yeah.
That's a really smart ward.
And they have a triple jungle, so this is going to hurt them a bit. Hey, man, did manage to block off the medium-sized creep camp there.
Mm-hmm.
Enigma's pretty happy currently farming this one out.
I was wondering how this is going to affect him with Nightstalker, because at the time, this is the problem in the Dignitas strat. When they're going to push, Nightstalker's going to hit nighttime, unless they push a little bit earlier than what they would normally do. And that's going to be my big question of what's going to happen right now. Like, Pass is going to get absolutely nothing on bottom. He has realized this so damn much. And Leaver's got to make sure he outfarms that bottom lane Freezer. But Freezer also having the best time of his life. So 6-4, sure, your deniers are okay. Makuro on the top playing as that on the middle lane. There's the faceless Void. He's got 8-1. Leaf has 10-2. So Dignitas are being outfarmed in their respective side lanes as well.
Hmm. Well, I think what they could do right now is, since Nightstalker is not up against anyone right now, I think Ariana, they've realized it by now, they might put the Ancient Apparition, because he obviously hasn't dropped the Sentry Wards either, since no spots were blocked. Mm-hmm. He could just come into mid lane, drop the Sentry Wards for that Broodmother, so Lich can harass her all the time.
That would be a good thing to do.
At least, in my opinion, making more use of the Ancient Apparition. Kind of what he's doing is controlling the creep lane, fair enough, and gaining farm and levels for himself.
Might be what the courier's flying up there for. The courier is currently empty, so he's probably looking to transfer something down.
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah,
this
so...
Make a lot of sense. Like putting a...
Yep, there you go.
Into, yeah.
World good. Swap over.
Very good move there.
Enigma is almost level 3. Come With Me is level 3, and it's going to TP back to base and get himself a little bit more mana before he's going to come out.
He's got no mana, though. He's got no mana. He's got no items right now.
Yeah, that's why he just went back to base.
Soul Ring. Yeah, Soul Ring. No, Soul Ring is coming. Okay, now that's perfect. Enigma with the Soul Ring can jungle indefinitely.
Mm-hmm.
All the time. Yeah.
Just want to know when they're going to push this tier 1 tower. They've got to do it soon. If they don't get an advantage from this, if they don't force the Dire side out of their lanes, then... This whole double jungle lane is for naught.
Triple.
Yeah, sorry, triple jungle. Like I keep on forgetting that Freezer is actually technically solo on that bottom lane, even though VS exactly. is in the neighborhood.
Yeah, as in Freezer is soloing as well. He's got complete free farm since Windrunner doesn't come onto the lane.
Hmm. I love what Alex is doing here in the middle lane. He's not throwing down the Sentry Ward. Now, okay, now he throws down the Sentry Ward. But he had those Sentry Wards for a while and showed himself the Broodmother, saying, I've got these. And because of that, Leon spent a little bit more time out of the lane. Like, he was just back a little bit further. There's a lot of damage being done to him, but he won't go down.
I'm really surprised he didn't pop that Rover. He was off cooldown.
What is Alex doing?
I have no idea.
Dude, that's a tower. That thing actually has a desire to kill you now. Bottom lane, this should be our first initiation. It's going to go on past VS Dust with his stun.
And
NS pauses the game.
What the hell?
This is the... What? Okay, Alex can't move.
Alex is playing Lich, yeah. Okay, that would at least explain why... First of all, they didn't pop their Nova on the Broodmother while she was still in range, because that would have been a very easy kill.
Mm-hmm. It's probably why I took the damage.
No idea there was a sentry there. Well, he had no idea. And then he popped the Nova on the creep and took a few tower hits.
Man, just look at Pass on the bottom lane. You got a Prophet TPing in. You've got Zuzu's already stunned him. Enigma has 2 levels on the Malphite, so that's going to be 2 stuns. He's still got that to cast. And then you got Freezer with his arrow, and Prophet's going to sprout. No matter what Pass does, even if he gets like the wind run and the path of his life, he is still going to die on this bottom lane. Actually, then he can just Prophet of Sprout. Yeah, he's got 1 level on Sprout and 2 on the Treants.
No idea what they're trying to do. But, well, in short, Windrun is dead.
Yep. And T1 Tower is gone.
And T1 Tower is gone, and Ariana missed a kill on mid lane. Like 100% kill.
Yeah.
Dignitas had no idea. That's why it looks like they're a little bit angry currently, because they think, well, what was wrong?
Yeah.
But if they actually would be in the same situation as Ariana, I guess they would understand perfectly what was going on.
It's like, we can't control our Lich. Small trouble.
Small trouble. We just missed the first blood on Broodmother for Void. Yeah.
Yeah. And now they're going to give it to the bottom lane. I'm interested to see if Mirana is the one who gets the last hit in this fight. Because Mirana's already got a decent amount of money. Like, we got Boots, Wraithband, 819 gold in the bank account. Add a first blood to that. Like, what's our farm sitting at? Freezer's 23 for 11. Not too shabby. Even though Leaf is out farming, 28 for 3 for the Nightstalker, because he is completely unattended on the top lane. And then 20 to 4 on Kuro in the middle. But this kill will make up for it. I still love that Zuzu has managed to get on it. I got to stop calling him Zuzu. It's not Zuzu.
Whatever.
Z! Yeah. Alright, so they're good to go. And pass, arrow hits, gone, skis. VS gets the first hit. I love it. VS, about to say, has got not single last hit on a creep, and he gets the first blood.
Yeah. Always a nice thing to have, really.
Yeah.
More hero kills than creeps.
And now with the DD rune, they're doing a lot of damage to that tier 1 tower. They'll let it go. In the meantime, though, Leaf as well as Saga are doing some damage towards that tier 1 tower on the top lane.
Yeah. It's two heroes pushing one lane and four heroes pushing the other lane, really, but they won't stop at the tower. They're going to go for the tier 2 as well.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure, I'm very, very sure, even that Ariana are not going to defend it, because they can't.
Yeah.
And come on!
Alright, so they're still having some issues with it. And Alex actually just resumes the game itself, says, screw it, man, like, I've got this. I'm like, I'm attacking your spiderling next to the tower. I'm auto-attacking. Why is he auto-attacking?
No idea.
I think there is something seriously wrong with the Lich in the middle lane. Tier 2 tower in the bottom lane is gone nonetheless, and Demon Tusk, they're not going to stop. And this is what I was saying. They don't stop for no man.
No, they don't. They don't stop.
They don't need to.
I don't think they can push into the base, honestly.
They're going to do it. 5 minutes and they're looking for a barracks. The tier 3 tower is going to force heroes back. This is what they want. Even if they don't bring down this tower, which they're already going to down a half HP, because really, Arya's not ready to push back yet. The German's not ready for this.
He's still wandering around like a madman, and he's still not moving.
Mm-hmm.
And once again, Lich is just not moving.
Yeah, Lich is trying to get back to the base. And this is something they need to sort out, because if they can't rally heroes back soon enough, like, Nightstalker's already there looking for a TP.
It's very close to being nighttime. It's around 20 seconds till nighttime.
Kuro has no TP scroll. AA is not level 6, and he has no TP. So this is going to be a 3-man battle on the bottom lane. Pass is already setting up for the power shot.
Well, Kuro should let the TP scroll come at least. So in TP once he's level 6. Now that he's level 5, it's completely useless.
Mm-hmm.
Lich is currently disconnected. I believe he's restarting Steam.
Yeah. Well, he's just restarting his entire PC. So something is seriously wrong with him. But they need to fix this. They really need to fix this.
It's already too late. They're going to get the base tower right now.
Yeah.
It's already too late.
Yeah, nothing is going to stop that. Even with a TP in from Nightstalker, nothing is going to stop that. The only question I'm going to have right now is there going to be any comeuppance? Like, VS still has a stun, so if they need to get back, they can do so. Morana has a leap. Enigma has his Malphus, as well as there's being a decent creep wave here, and Prophet has his TP. Well, so technically, Dignitas could get out of this unscathed.
They can. Well, I think they will, also. I think there's 100% base tower right now. Mm-hmm. Because it's not nighttime just yet. Leaf is preparing to TP, but he's also not 6 yet, so he doesn't have his ultimate to rely on. He needs to wait for nighttime until he can do something. Windrunner is completely underleveled. He's only level 2. In contrast to Wild Dignitas, they have left top lane completely. They didn't have a single hero put there. But VS was jungling together with Enigma. So, in contrast to Windrunner, VS is actually level 4.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, VS has got level 4 and Ori's got 1 level of Command Aura. Very good for pushing.
Mm. Of course, for those guys from the Water Dota 2, we do have that fun time when Warcraft 3 names do go over. So, Command Aura is now known as Vengeance Aura. In the world of Dota 2.
Oh, is it? Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. I actually haven't realized it.
Yeah. There's small name changes here and there, like it's an Ogre Club instead of an Ogre Axe. Just these little things that have been changed up because, obviously, Warcraft 3 have copyright to a lot of the definitions, the names of a lot of it.
They do, and Blizzard has recently even filed a complaint to Valve with a trademark thing, I believe.
Looks like there's some issues with Steam itself. I believe Steam is actually down right now.
Oh yeah, it looks like it. I'm currently marked as offline.
Which is going to be a bit of a problem right now because he won't be able to reconnect back in again. Because he won't be able to connect to Steam. So Alex is restarting, but he can't reconnect back into Steam again. So We're going to be down. We're going to be back here in a couple of moments' time. So we're going to split this VOD up into twine, and we'll be back here with part two of your VOD in just a couple of moments' time.
I said good day, sir.